What makes this season extra special is we got it right. People are going to fall in love with the stories of some of the characters on the race. Art and JJ are like brothers, and I think a real advantage they have is that they spend all the time together.
That's how we roll.
They're out patrolling the border, working together in really stressful, difficult situations, and so that's going to come in really handy on the race. They've certainly got on each other's nerves before.
Art.
What?
So whatever stresses and strains that they face on the race, they definitely got experience in terms of working it out together. Carrie and Stacy, cousins, very fit. They really want to come on this race to have a good time. It's either going to really work for them, and the other teams are going to really love them and want to embrace their wild personalities. Or it's going to work against them and they're just going to get left behind. Rachel and Dave, they're a really interesting team. He is the best of what the military has to offer. She's very fit and an equal match physically. In fact, I would say that of all the teams, they're the one team that I'm really interested in watching in terms of what's going to happen to their relationship and their connection because they've spent so much time apart. Elliot and Andrew are twins and yet kind of yin and yang. They look the same, but they're not. Well, let's put it this way. One has long hair, one has short hair. One is a musician, the other one's a professional sports person. One is used to staying up late at night, partying all night, being a part of the music scene, and the other one is used to getting up for early morning training sessions to go play professional soccer. I think they could be a bit of a distraction to some of the women on the team. Good-looking guys. I think they've got a good balance of complementing skills, and obviously being brothers, being identical twins, they got a lot in common, and definitely a force. Neri and Jamie are federal agents. These are two women that you don't want to mess around with. They have firearms. They have used them. They're used to using deadly force when it's needed. They're competitors, and they're used to being focused.
They're on the left side, to the right.
And because they are cute, I think people will inherently underestimate them. And at some point, they're going to get a real shock.
One, two, three.
Sherry and Dave.
Dave and Sherry.
Dave and Sherry are two clowns. They want to take their humor around the world, and they feel that their humor and using their humor is going to be a great way for them to open doors and make the race a little easier for them. Juggling. Jokes. Noses. Clowning around. When Vanessa and Ralph started the race on bicycles, seriously, there was so much weight on top of the bicycle from Ralph that I thought this bike is either not going to stay together or he's just going to topple over. I'm not even kidding. I think his arms were as big as his legs. Crazy. I expect that somewhere along the race, she is going to have some words with some of the other female competitors. I think she's going to be the one that's going to really charge that team forward. And I think he's going to be dragging his heels a wee bit behind her, just because of her personality. And he'll definitely be backing her up because he's got the muscle and he's got the fitness and he's got the focus. But I think she's going to take the leadership role. Bopper and Mark have a pretty challenging existence. They're really struggling right now. I don't know if we've ever had anybody on the race that is so strongly motivated to win the money to buy their way out of a situation that they're in.
Meal time!
But they're going to be exposed to other people around the world, some of whom may be worse off than they are. And I think that's going to be quite enlightening for them. That might give them an extra fight to hang on and work out a way to change their existence. I hope that this does change their life for the better. Misa and Maya, they're definitely an all-female team that have the potential to beat out any of the teams just because of their smarts and also their physical ability. How could these two beautiful-looking sisters, you know, compete with somebody like Ralph or Dave? You know, who is this top military guy? The potential for really interesting things to happen, really interesting competition to happen on this race is all there. And I think they're gonna be a major part of that. Joey Fitness and Danny, it's not just six packs. I think it's like a 10 pack that these guys have got. How many ever ab muscles exist in the human body? They've got them all. And you know, they really enjoy showing everybody too. If you were writing a screenplay and you were picking Jersey guys and you were trying to find like the stereotypical Jersey guy, hey, these are the guys, you know what I'm saying? These are the guys. They're definitely not lacking in confidence and they think that they have the situation under control, so to speak. It'll be a shock to the system for them for sure. Brendan and Rachel, people are fascinated by this team. People love to hate them. They will not disappoint because the other teams immediately identified them as the team that were from Big Brother. Why should they get another shot? It immediately created tension at the starting line. There were looks. There will be tension. Everybody on this race, I think, has the potential to win. We've got a lot of teams who are used to focusing on challenges and achieving goals. When you throw so many A-types and so many dominant personalities together at one time, and they're all trying to get one thing, $1 million, and get to the finish line first, I think it will be another sensational race.